Hello again, everybody. It's Scott Casper. Takedown Media. Our coverage of the sport continues today. We head to Blacksburg, Virginia. Joey Dance is going into the Nike hot seat today. Joey, welcome back. How are you?
Good, Scott. How about you, man?
I'm good. I'm so proud of what you have accomplished at VTech. And I'll tell you what, I got to see you up close. I got to see you personally. Got to see you on the national stage, wrestling in the conference. You lit this thing up. You did such an outstanding job for the Hokies. But the news is out now. You're going to be leaving there and venturing west. So before we get to talk about your role on the Northwestern Regional Training Center staff, it's going to be fun. I know it's going to be fun. But let's go back and visit this last year. Unfinished business, regrets. Gosh, you had so many great accomplishments over your time in Virginia Tech. Can you talk about them?
It's definitely been a roller coaster ride. I mean, obviously I didn't get what I ultimately wanted, which was a national title. I mean, really my goal going into college was being more than just a one-time national champ, but I got two-time All-American instead. I mean, I'm still happy I got it this year. Freshman year was definitely a fun year. I actually didn't have that great of a regular season, and so that was definitely a big roller coaster ride for me. Just that year alone, went from I lost like 10 matches that year, and then every year after that I lost maybe like one or two. And my freshman year was my best year, which was strange, but the 2 years in the middle of my sophomore, junior year, those were definitely the toughest years of wrestling I've ever had. I had a lot of problems, I feel like, mentally, just kind of going into the national tournament. I almost kind of pulled myself back a little bit and decided not to do as much offense as I normally should. And so that kind of restricted me, and I just was worried more about not losing than actually going out and wrestling. And so that's something that I feel like I changed up my senior year and actually had fun with the sport and really enjoyed everything. And I'm glad I finished with All-American status, but, I mean, obviously I always wanted more.
Wasn't there an injury you had that almost kept you from wrestling and moving on? Was there an injury?
It wasn't that serious, but my junior year, it was against the match against Jeske. I tore my ankle pretty good. I actually had a tear in one of my ligaments and then a sprain on that same match. And so my ankle was pretty banged up then, and I couldn't really wrestle that match. And then I got knocked out of the tournament then. And let's see. Actually, later that summer, too, I was getting back training, and I had a bad injury to my knee. I had bursitis really bad, and it got infected because we drained it so much during the summer. And when we drained it, we realized that the color that came out of my knee did not look good at all. It was actually looked like a strawberry milkshake. And so we went off and got that tested, and I actually had staph in my knee. And so if we would have waited maybe another few weeks, I probably could have lost my leg how serious it was. And so I actually got surgery on my knee, then got all that fixed up and was ready to go my senior year.
I don't think Kevin Dresser could have been any more proud of a young man and the way you worked through that, but also the way you wrestled, dude. I remember the 2013-14 season going 28-10. Year after that, 28-4. That's a marked improvement in my book, but also you earned an ACC title, which I always said that the East would rise again, and on the backs of Virginia Tech and NC State and at times, other programs as well, but mostly Virginia Tech and NC State. Some great battles there within those two schools, between those two schools. Did you have fun?
Yeah, NC State's definitely coming up right there, man. They're a really good program, and they're definitely competing with us. And I mean, obviously when we think about it, we're like, oh, NC State isn't as good as us, but they're right there, man. They're doing a great job. The East Coast is definitely, just like you said, the East Coast is rising up. And so I'm excited to see what Virginia Tech's going to do in the future. I mean, who knows? Maybe after I'm done at Northwestern, I might come back and be the head coach of Virginia Tech. That's something that I would love to do, man. I would love to come back to Virginia and give back to the sport in that way. And that would be an awesome like stamp to my college life, really. And so, I mean, as ending at Virginia Tech and being the head coach, that would be great.
Oh, that would be awesome. Now, they've rolled out the carpet. Matt Storniolo and company in Chicago at Northwestern University. It's the Big Ten. You're moving into Big Ten country. He said, could not be more excited to announce that the Chicago Regional Training Center has a new resident athlete. He is an awfully good wrestler. He's Joey Dance. Welcome to Chicago. How about that? How did this whole thing come about?
I mean, I had a few visits lined up, and Northwestern was actually my first visit. Before I went to Northwestern, I was not very excited to go. I went to New York. I did not like New York, didn't like the city. I was raised in the country. I'm a country boy. And so I wasn't expecting to like Chicago at all, but it was the complete opposite, man. I went to Chicago. We actually, I didn't even know that there was it Lake Michigan was right next to Chicago. I didn't even know that. So we were flying over Chicago about to land. And I was like, wait, we're not near the ocean. I know we're not near the ocean right now because of how massive that lake was. And I was like, oh, well, I have my lake right here. I have a place to go and swim and stuff like that. I've always wanted to be near the water. And then when I looked at the city, it was just so clean. The people were so nice. It was nothing like New York City, what I kind of was comparing it to. It just really really drew me in. And then just the coaching staff, too. I got along really well with Storniolo, Jason Welch, Brewer, and Andrew Howe. They're great guys, man. They were awesome. I just connected with them so easily, and they made it really easy for me to make my decision. I actually canceled all my other offers after that.
Wow. So how important was Cody Brewer and the role he played in, you know, conversations and what you know of Cody and how well you know him? How much of a role did Cody Brewer have in your decision?
I mean, obviously, I mean, he played a big role in. I mean, that's someone I can work out with on a day-to-day basis. And I mean, Cody Brewer is a good guy to work out with. Obviously, he did really well at the U.S. Open this past weekend. I mean, he won a NCAA championship, something that I never did. And so, I mean, that's going to be any wrestler in the weight class above me too. So, I mean, I'll get that feel too. It's always nice to wrestle a guy that's a little bit bigger than you too. And so, I mean, he's a goer too. That's another thing what I like about him. He goes the whole time. He doesn't stop. He doesn't have that style where he kind of just waits, then attacks. He just is attacking the whole time. And that's the workout partner that I really think could really get me to like this next level that I want to be at and actually make a world team and hopefully make the Olympic team in 2020. That's something that I'm really shooting for. I would love to go to Tokyo. I would love for my mom to see me out in Tokyo and win an Olympic title.
We're talking to Joey Dance, two-time Division I All-American, and he will go on tour all over the East and deep into the middle of it as well. But you're going to be doing some camps and clinics. Do you still have open dates?
I mean, I always can make some room. I'll talk to Storny even when I'm in Chicago. And so I'll see what he thinks and see if I can kind of travel around a little bit more and maybe do some more camps and make some more money this summer. I'm sure he'll be okay with it. And so if there's any dates that you guys feel like that are open or any dates you guys would like me to come down, and then I could try to open up my schedule and get down there. Cause I mean, I love giving back to the wrestling community. And so that's something I love to do. I mean, I love wrestling, and I love learning new stuff, and hopefully I can actually go out and do more clinics and camps this year. So yeah, hopefully I can do it this summer.
I know you've got a mini camp coming up, Matt Savvy Wrestling Club, May 7th, 2-7 at Lincoln Middle School in Lynchburg, Virginia. So folks, coaches, if you're interested in having Joey Dance join you in one of your camps and clinics this summer, you can do it. Look for him on Facebook, Joey Dance, J-O-E-Y, Dance, D-A-N-C-E. I've got to say that you know, I'm really excited to see you prepare for international competition. I think that's going to be the best of all. We get to continue watching you compete. 100% healthy right now?
Yeah, I'm feeling good right now. I mean, obviously, I had a little dings after season this year, but I got all that taken care of. I'm excited to move on and start my international career. Watching the U.S. Open this past weekend was definitely hard for me. But I mean, I didn't go because I had a kind of a family emergency with my mom, and she got hurt pretty bad, and so I ended up going. I actually was planning on going, and I mean, I would have loved to compete at the U.S. Open, but I had family first, and that's what I was really worried about, was my mom. So
yeah, we'll talk about your mom in a moment. I do have to ask you to expound on your thoughts of the U.S. Open. What are your thoughts on your weight class?
There's a lot of good guys at the weight. A lot of good guys at the weight. There's I mean, heck, you got national champs. You got guys that are right there in the Olympic ladder. You got like Tony Ramos. You got Nico Magaludis. You got Nathan Tomasello. You got Pirelli, Sanders, Nashawn Garrett. I mean, then the list goes on. You could name every single one of those guys. And I feel like really any one of those guys, if they represented the team in 2020, they would do a great job. But obviously, I'm not rooting for them. I'm going to be rooting for myself. And so hopefully when 2020 comes around, I'll be ready to go and ready to hopefully knock those guys off.
Yeah. So, okay. Well, let's go back just a minute. You're not going to root for those guys. You're going to root for yourself. Is that how it works? Joey Dance, the comedian, joining us on the show in the Nike hot seat. I hope you're comfortable in the Nike hot seat today. You're one of the guys that's real easy to work around, real easy to work with, real likable. Teammates always talk about you, that type of thing. I don't know where that started, but your high school coach is often talks about the energy that you had in high school, and at Christiansburg, and it's still happening. I think, I don't even know. Is there a switch on and a switch off at the end of the day?
I mean, not really. I have a little puppy now, and so I definitely have to keep that same switch on for him. And so I have a cat too, and so I have to definitely keep energized throughout the whole day. And I mean, I don't know. My family's really the same way, and so I mean, being around them, I'm always really energized. I'm always in a good mood. I always want to be smiling, even though I mean, bad stuff can happen. I mean, especially with my mom and everything. But I stay positive through that. I stay positive through everything I do. Just, I feel like it's, I mean, there's really no reason to be negative about anything. So I feel like everyone kind of thrives off positivity, and that's what I try to do. I try to stay positive like every single day of my life. And I feel like that's helped me out, and that's why I'm here. That's why I'm here where I'm at now.
What's your puppy's name? Joey, what's your puppy's name?
You there, Scott?
I am. Can you hear me? No? Joey Dance, our guest.
I think I lost you a little bit.
Are you there now?
Yeah, I hear
you. Okay, very good. What's your puppy's name, Joey?
Mako.
Where is he at right now?
Just like a shark. He's actually right over here chewing on a bone.
Can you get him for me?
Yeah, I'll grab him.
I think we're experiencing a little bit of a delay in my audio to Joey. And the reason I want to have him show you Mako... There's Mako. What's up, Mako? Have you told Mako yet about your shark killing expedition?
I've told him, but I don't think he really understands why I named him Mako. And so, yeah, I'm guessing you saw that on Facebook.
Oh, big time, man. That's a big fish.
Yeah, it was 8 foot, about 300 pounds. And that was, I did that actually right after NCAAs. The next week we left for Miami and we had the trip set up, and, it was a 4-hour trip, and the last 3 minutes of the trip, the captain stopped the boat, and he was like, "All right, guys, we're not catching anything. We're going to go ahead and reel him up." And right when we were about to reel it up, we hooked an 8-foot, 300-pound Mako shark, and so that was an awesome, awesome experience.
A lot of teeth, man. Did you get to keep any of the teeth?
We actually tried to knock one out, but I'm actually going to get it mounted and everything, so we want to keep the teeth intact, and that way it looks good for the mount.
I hope you got them in a freezer. Those things tend to spoil.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, Mako's having fun. Okay, now let's get serious. This is how I want to end. Your mom, Sylvia, was injured at work on the job, and was actually behind a pallet jack of kind of sorts, if you will, moving some stuff, and her back went up against a railing, and the handle of the trolley, if you will, went through her, injuring. Can you take me from there? Injured her?
Yeah. Well, she went to the hospital right after that, obviously. And, I got a call from my dad, and that's when I saw everything about, Iowa State. And so I thought my dad, sorry, Mako's being a little shithead, but I got the call from my dad, and it was right at the same time that Brent Metcalf and Zadek got accepted to, or they were the coaches of Iowa State. And so I thought my dad was calling me about that. So I answered the phone. I was like, "Yeah, did you see Iowa State got that call? I mean, did you see Iowa State picked up Zadek and Metcalf?" And instead of him talking about that, he was crying. So right when I answered the phone, he was just bawling. And I've never heard my dad cry before. I've never seen him cry. And so I was like, "Oh, this is serious." And he told my mom got in a bad accident, and he said to get to Richmond as fast as I can. He actually had one of his buddies come pick me up, and I drove from Blacksburg to Richmond and saw my mom. And I guess I didn't really realize how bad the injury was. I was trying to stay positive the whole time. Like I told you before, I try to stay positive with whatever happens in my life.
Right.
And so I was staying positive, and the doctor pulled me aside, and he pretty much told me how serious it was. He was like, "I'm not sure how much longer she's gonna have, and so we need to make sure to be strong for her. And hopefully she can push through it." And that's what she did. She pushed through it. And right now she's actually walking and she's talking. She's doing really great right now. And so her goal is right now is to make it to my graduation next week.
Joseph Green, Dance the Fourth. We wish your mom, Sylvia, the best in her recovery. And I got to believe that between your dad, Joe, and your mom, Sylvia, you're getting a lot of strength. But you know the wrestling community is behind you, 100% behind her recovery as well. Awful lot of fun watching you compete, dude.
I haven't really said much about it on social media. But, I mean, yeah, it's definitely something that I didn't want to, like, get out there too much. But obviously, I mean, I know the wrestling community has my back with everything I do. And so, I mean, if I was to tell anyone, I mean, really everyone that supports me in wrestling, I mean, those are the best people, and I know they're going to be there for me and be there to back me up and my family. I know a lot of the wrestling community knows my family and probably knows my mom too. And so just we really appreciate all your guys' prayers. So thank you.
You betcha. You know, October 22nd of 1993, we got a gift. Wrestling fans, his name's Joseph Green, Dance the Fourth. How about that? The legend was born that day. It continues and will on the campus of Northwestern University at the regional training center there. The news is out, and Storniolo couldn't be any happier. Brewer and company, everybody up there so excited to have you get to Chicago and begin your next step. Joey, thanks for the time today, brother. It's always good to talk to you, and I'm looking forward to our next visit.
Yeah, no problem, Scott. It's good talking to you, man.
Take care of Mako, will you?
I will.
Remember, you're the boss.
Yeah, I know. It's hard with him, especially. He thinks he's the boss of everything around here. I got two to worry about. I got Mako and my cat.
What's your cat's name?
Simba. He's he's about 23 pounds. Oh, he's right there messing with Mako right now.
Have a fun rest of your day, brother. Best to your mom and dad, okay?
Appreciate it, Scott. Have a good one.
For all of us at Takedown, our very special guest on the Nike Hot Seat today has been an absolute stud. Won at Virginia Tech. Before that, at Christiansburg High School for Darrell Weber. It's been a joy catching up with him today. And do continue to offer your prayers to his mother, Sylvia, in her recovery. God bless. We'll talk to you soon. I'm Scott Casper for Takedown.